Hi, so we made it to 1,000 subscribers and okay, so I just want to say thank you, but this is not some sappy you know, thank you, although I'm quite emotional. Just kidding, guys. I'm just really thankful. 1,000 subscribers might not be a lot to people, but like, this channel's been through a lot. I thought it would be fitting to react to some of my old YouTube videos. I get so much shit. I guess I did, if you didn't know, I did YouTube in like 2012 when it wasn't cool. If you did YouTube back in 2012, you were either an idiot or, that's basically happened. So for you guys, I'm gonna react to, you know, some embarrassing videos, but I just wanna show you guys that you evolve, and I've been through so many passions and hobbies, right? You'll see some of them. It includes playing with dolls. I just switched from many passions, guys. You guys just should realize that you guys can be multi-dimensional, and never ever let anybody tell you who you are. Don't let anyone tell you who you are, and just do anything you want. So here it is. I don't know if it's just me. I'm already getting a headache, like a minor headache, just from like pulling my computer. I really don't want to do this. So I just want to tell you the history of my YouTube career. It started out in 2012 with dolls, with a channel called Kitty Films 8. Do not Google it. It's not there anymore, okay? Kitty Films 8 is gone because it's privated, but I still have the videos, so we're gonna react to that. But there's this one channel that hasn't been deleted yet because I forgot the password, and my dad did too, and my mom, and we're just stuck here living with these videos, and occasionally I'll have friends who just watch it. So we're gonna start with Kitty Films 8. I basically stopped because people were getting on my nerves, and I was really nervous to post, and I was just kind of scared to get made fun of again. Long story short, I just stopped making videos because people called me an idiot. But I guess we're okay. Actually, I decided not to show Kitty Films 8. I think I'll save it for the next milestone we reach, because that the other channel is pure gold. This though is like cringe. This is like the definition of cringe. Okay, this is a touchy subject for me, because I went to my first day of high school with these big seniors playing my old YouTube videos on the big projector screen, and I was scarred. And I was like, what the fuck is this high school? About 117 more videos. So we're gonna watch it, and please like and subscribe, because I'm losing my dignity by the minute. Okay, you don't understand, like, this is really embarrassing for me. I'm already looking at the thumbnail. Okay. We're gonna do the first video called Beauty Channel Intro, Vlogging and Randomness. Alright. August 13, 2012. Dude, I was a vlogger back then. Are you kidding me? Like, not only was it just like, you know, me getting made fun of, but like, people do this still to this day. Like, to this day, I get messages from my friends that show me my old videos, and I just want to cry. It's not because, like, I don't know, I think it's just a scarring moment in middle school. Okay, tough it up, Jade. I love objection.
I am filming in the car, obviously. If you don't know me, I am Kitty Films 8.
You see that, Kitty Films 8? But this is like a new channel. I'll have to do like the Kitty Films 8 channel later, because this is like when I transferred over to beauty. I started with dolls and like playing with, you know, little toys, and I started to do beauty in 2012.
Thank you, Mom. So, this is my new beauty channel.
Thank you, Mom, because I was riding in the backseat. Not much has changed.
It's called Jade Paris Couture.
Okay, I had a thing with names. Like, I changed from Kitty Films 8 to Jade Paris Couture, Jade Paris Couture for my beauty channel. Anyways.
Which is a lot, because I kind of like sewing my clothes, so it's going to be my brand name too.
It's gonna be my brand name. This bitch.
Just thought that I could do like a vlogging around for my intro of my first video on my beauty channel. So right now I am going to a link for a photo shoot. Yeah, I look dressed.
A photo shoot. Where are you going? And a little bonus. If you are at this point, I made a podcast version of my last video. I know this, you guys wanted to just have it on the go. A lot of you guys know it's like pretty long. It's a 20-minute video. So I made it into a podcast version for it to be convenient. You can listen to it on the car. And don't worry, there's gonna be more announcements in regards to the podcast. But since you guys are my 1,000 subscriber family, like, you know, this group of people right now, I thought announce it here first. I'm gonna show you guys, if you look at my neck, I'm just naming random things, but like, I have really bad eczema to this day, but it was horrible. I was like in a wheelchair back there when I was in fifth grade, I believe. So me filming with my like neck exposed was like kind of like a big step. Like, this girl is so confident. My makeup looks kind of good, not gonna lie. Whatever. All right, next video. Should we do a makeup tutorial? I feel like it's not as funny because my editing was like kind of low-key good back then, so it wasn't that embarrassing. But this is called Inspired Everyday K-pop Look.
Hey guys, I have this really cute everyday K-pop look, and yes, I'm wearing fake bangs, but shh, nobody will know.
Okay, that's enough of that one. I do so many vlogs. There's another vlog with my friend Brianna. I did a lot of DIYs. I don't know which one to watch. I honestly did a lot of makeup, and I want to do something really interesting, so we're gonna... Okay, this one is low-key just, like, assaulting. So we're gonna watch it.
Hey my squirrels, today I'm going to teach you how to get this natural yet dramatic makeup look. I know those two words do not go together, but I found a way to make it work, and I'm just about to go
I think I'm going to show you guys when I started getting a little bit more high production. My editing got a little better. This was my first like makeup entry video for like a competition for makeup. I really like makeup back in the day, okay? So this is quite high production, not going to lie. We're gonna watch it. I worked so hard on this, you don't even know. Kinda got a lot of views too, what the heck?
Hello, and welcome to my paradise. This fierce makeup-
Loki slaying.
For the colors of spring.
She cute.
Hope you enjoy.
Dude, this is low-key good though. Like, look at the editing and like the background. I filmed in like, okay, I live like in like these kind of like crummy apartments, but they're quite nice now they're renovated. Anyways, but I literally filmed in front of multiple backyards of people. Like, it wasn't my private, like it wasn't a private backyard. It's like a courtyard, so like this girl had some guts.
With a flat shader.
Oh, by the way, my mom filled this for me because she's a freaking G.
I'm gonna take this mint green color from this funny tropical.
I don't even know. That's not even embarrassing. That's kind of cute. Sorry. My eyebrows were atrocious though. I think let's try to do, this is when I started doing a lot more. I was inspired by other YouTubers. So my style really changed. I wasn't being really myself. I was trying to portray another YouTuber. Her name's like Adeline. If you guys know her, she makes great videos, but I really tried hard. So I think my editing changed a lot. And anyways, here's a DIY Rubik's Cube costume, okay?
Guys, it's gonna be a Halloween tutorial on a Rubik's Cube.
Awkward situation.
So this is probably the most fun.
Girl, your camera ain't focused on your face.
You won't see anybody else walking in a cube during Halloween.
There's a reason why no one will see you walking in a cube, because that's Halloween. Stupid. Oh, my friend is Symphony. Shout out to her. She's like my best friend in middle school. We were gonna be walking Rubik's Cubes together.
Anyways, I'm gonna do a DIY costume. Maybe like a
girl, focus the camera on your face.
Yeah, it's under $10, which is rent. So let's get started.
Rolling and running across the sky. And I hope that.
Loki kind of nice, the editing. Wait, wait for it. Okay, if you were wondering, that it was, the whole video was a tutorial on how to make a giant Rubik's Cube.
Hey guys, it has been too long. Today is March.
Did you see the phone case?
We're gonna do a tag.
We're gonna do a tag.
TMI tag.
I wanna say this is embarrassing, but I'm literally like low-key the same person inside. Yeah.
What are you wearing? Forever 21, baby. Ever been in love? Nope.
Not much has changed. What is love?
Ever had a terrible breakup? Never been in love.
Actually, I did have a terrible breakup.
How much do you weigh? This is kind of embarrassing, but I eat a lot, but I'm 104 pounds.
Oh my gosh. That makes me really sad. I used to have like a really bad eating problem. I went to like the hospital last year, but I can't believe I said that. Back in sixth grade, I eat a lot of food and I'm 104 pounds. This girl, I feel bad. This is the last video we're gonna see. It's a back to school outfit, 2014. Guessing? My editing low key was so good. Jamie, why did I choose them?
You are late to class.
What? You don't know what I'm going through. Like, I had to change my entire summer wardrobe into something real appropriate because I'm not, like, I'm on a point. And if I'm not on a point, like,
oh, if you didn't know, I had this acting phase. There's so much stuff you guys don't know about me.
Honestly, let's start the school year ready.
Oh, this gave me the chills. This is kind of cute. I grew up
so nice to reuse your summer pieces. Into your back to school outfit, Lego.
This song was a bot back in the day. Dude, I changed so much. Why was I kind of cute? Okay, I just want to say I'm glad we left this video on a high note. If you guys want part two, just let me know. I honestly regret not like fully doing YouTube. I regret just stopping, taking breaks because I was afraid what people think. I regret that whole thing. If I kept going since 2010 when I started, don't feel like what I'm feeling. Like, don't have this regret, just start something. It's just insane how this journey has gone through, but I'm at least I documented these videos and I didn't delete them. So yeah, I honestly truly believe if I kept going from 2010 when YouTube wasn't big and there was just such a bigger market, you know, it was so much easier to get like, you know, famous or viewed on YouTube back in the day. Now it's such a saturated competitive market. So I honestly could have been like, I don't know, man, if I kept going, I could have been like a million subscribers, I swear. But you know, we always start somewhere. And everyone has a different path. So if you've made it all the way to the end, make sure you comment below, I made it, or just say something. Just please let me know if this was entertaining because I had so much fun making it. And it's really cool to see some, you know, throwback videos. All right, guys. So again, I just really appreciate every single one of you. And it really makes me it motivates me to keep going, seeing your comments, your reactions, you know, your thumbs ups, honestly, like truly means the world. But if you could subscribe to the podcast down below on iTunes or SoundCloud, that'd be amazing. I'll check you guys in the next one. Goodbye.